love it.
We gotta straighten this out. There's the before. It's in bad shape. Filing a power saw in the back of a pickup. Hey, these are little tips. These are things we get into doing all the time, friends.
That's usually what we do. See that? We just put a card in there, you see? And it moves around in there good, you see? And then pull that out. It's tight, but see, it pulls out. Is that?
So I hope these little things can help you. You know? They sure, we do them all the time, so.
I'm just going to give you a little bit better of a look at it. It's exceptional. Actually, as a matter of fact, I traded him this saw for this. Look at it. Honestly, you know what they look like. They're usually looking like this, right? Just, you know the deal. Not this one. It's just crazy looking.
Oh, yeah, actually, this has been hit. But see, I can push on it. I can push hard. And the saw doesn't go anywhere because it's here, in here with me. And up there, it can't go anywhere. So it's actually quite solid. And the reason I put my armpit on it is so that the tip doesn't go down like that. And I just rest my body on it. Bending at the knees. Using your core if you need be. Okay, friends? So we're going to go give this a little slicey-dicey after. So you may as well hang with me. Let's just get this finished. We just started the 32-inch bar, so you guys can just kind of hang and watch the strokes.
Friends, good morning. I hope you're well. It's we've had a nice little run of weather. Hogan's been doing some stuff with Victor. I've been actually doing some stuff that I've wanted to do for a long time. I've had 2 850s, okay, sitting in the carport, in the saw shop, okay, two of them, that I knew one needed a carb kit because it had spark. Does anybody remember that really shiny 850? Who remembers the video where Victor almost took me out with a top? We were at about 100 feet, the both of us, and I was walking Victor through some tree work. And I said, Vic, you might want to turn that undercut a little bit. That's coming right at me. And he actually swept it right by, and the limbs hit the GoPro and everything. It was kind of funny. You know, it wasn't nuts, but it was funny. It was a good job. Actually, it's got quite a few views. It was I think the thumbnail might have something to do with it. It's Victor and Skinny Little Wood. So that was a big day for Victor. Okay, friends, listen, I just, there's something coming up in the video that I struggled with uploading. Okay, but it's not about me here. What you're going to see, it's not about me. It's about the gentleman who sent me this. It's a poem. It was a birthday poem that this man, the woodsman spirit, okay, friends, he's older than myself. He's not old by any means. He's got a ton of spirit. He's got the spirit of the woodsman in him. I love this guy, okay? He wrote me a poem, friends. He knows me from watching my videos. That's it. I've never met the man, okay? But I'm going to tell you, he's a gifted soul. He wrote this poem. Friends, I was blubbering. I'm just telling you right now, I was blubbering. But I'll tell you something. I uploaded it. I'm going to upload it. It's in this video. I do get emotional. I struggled spitting it out. Just the way a man can convey his message in words like that. It was tough to get through. It was tough to get through, but I put it up. I put it up. I don't care people seeing me, you know, moksha. I don't care about any of that crap. It doesn't bother me one bit, actually. I'm not embarrassed. I'm not nothing. So I uploaded it. Just be aware, I do get a little emotional. Warning.
Hey everybody, how's it going? How's everybody doing tonight? I hope well. I do, I hope you're doing well. I'm just on the back of the tailgate here, filing power saw. And it's one of those things, you get a long bar, even a short bar, friends. This is kind of what I do for filing a power saw on the back of a gate. This is the inside of the box, and this is the back of the tailgate. Like the back of the truck. I'm on the tailgate. Okay? And I basically just... I put it just right on the gate. But I put my tip, if I'm filing the right side of the chain, I put my tip up against so it can't move. And I just hug her. I get right on it so it can't move. You see, nothing's moving. And I'm able to file. You see? So this, having your tip stationary is quite the must, I think, when you're filing power saw. If you're in a vise, no big deal. But when you're out in the woods or you're on site and you want to get that sucker cutting again, the gate's a great place to do it. You can see what I'm doing, right? It's the tip. It's literally on the back of the truck and I'm pushing against it. And then when I switch, I'll show you. I'm almost done actually, so we'll just go through it. Some of these teeth need to have the gullet ripped out of them. That one there did, so I did a couple gullet strokes and then back into the regular routine. You see that, friends? Okay. This could use a couple. You see what I'm doing? See the angle of my file is down a bit. Not up or straight across. It's down. And then I sloop up so that I get the inside of the tooth to the inside of the gullet. Just like that. There's nothing wrong with it at all. Then your cleanup strokes, that's when you straighten out and get her going because you've just dug the gullet. It's just an easy, fast way to get the bottom of that chain out of there. The bottom of that tooth, cutter tooth, which is the gullet. Okay, you can get it straight like this. Just going straight like this too. There's no problem at all. You can get it. You just gotta push down. And that's the problem. A lot of guys won't push down and they'll kind of miss it. And it'll hurt. It'll hurt the cut. So I think what I'll do now, see, this is that thing I do. I call it the boat. And man, it works nice. Okay, so, oh, I think I'm done. Yeah, I am done. Oh, yeah. There we go. Let's just make sure. I always go over my first couple teeth because I'm getting into the swing of things. So I always go over the two or three, maybe four teeth that I started filing. So that's good. Yeah, very good. Okay, so now, as simple as this, friends, this is literally what I do. Watch. I bring it up over the gate, and now I put it up against the truck. Right like that. So now what you've got, you can go to the other side of the pickup if you want, but as long as you've got your tip up against the truck, like that, now you basically hug the saw. Let's get that piece of wood we had. There. Deadly. So now, I just basically throw my body over top. I've got my arm over the wrap my guts, you know, I'm on it. I'm right on the saw like this, you see? And now the tip is up against the truck. Now look, here we go. Sometimes if you want, you can kind of pull it back and use your arm. I use my arm on the wrap bar all the time. But the big thing is the tip, friends. Okay? Is the tip's not jumping around on you. Oh yeah, this thing was dull.
Shawshank, be nice to see you at Buckenstock. I really want you there, buddy. I really do, I'm not joking around. Be so nice to see you, bud. Shawshank was the fella that took me to Sweden, friends. I got the thing between my knees. Listen, the reason I'm in this video is because I want to read something to you. It was my 50th birthday present from the Woodsman Spirit, okay? He's a guy who is a lover of the axe, a lover of the outdoors. He's a man. He's a man, okay? We like things like that, sharp things in the bushes and the woods and working, right? That's why you see, you know, me and, like, we just work. That's what we do. Christine does, too. Don't think women don't work, because they do. And Christine will let you know about it. And if you say something about that, she'll take you right out, that Christine. I said in my video the other day, yesterday's video, when I was stacking the wood, I said, I don't know about you, but man, we got stuff to do like this. And right when I said it, when I watched it back and I said that, I was like, okay, I'm going to get some flack for that one. Because trust me, if anybody knows that women work, it's me. Both the women and all the women in my family, my mom is a freaking warrior. She don't work most men I know, straight up. My wife has a work ethic from, she's a worker. Rita, same deal. It's just where we come from. So why did I go there? Just because I thought about it. Christine. Friends, listen to this. I want to share this. This is a really neat woodsman. I hope you're watching, because it's been a while, friends. He sent, it's my 50th birthday, April 7th, right? Okay. Listen, this is really cool. It was well written. And this is not about me. This is about the woodsman, his craft for words. Okay. Listen to this. This is really nice. Buck and Billy Ray. Where did it go? Oh, here it is. Here it is, friends. Okay. This is nice. A Man Amongst Trees is the name of the video, or the name of the poem, okay? And he just come up with this fella, okay? He's an older gentleman, not old, but he's in his 60s. That was a compliment. He's probably hitting 70 now, aren't you, buddy? Anyway, friends, I'm kidding. In these times of selfishness, hate, and division, the good in mankind now shows and is risen. Buck and Billy Ray and his charm, humor, and wit, manly woodsman tough. Oh no, sorry, friends. Manly woodsman, though with the ladies is a hit. What a guy you are. Friends, let me start that again. I screwed it up. In these times of selfishness, hate, and division, the good in mankind now shows and is risen. Buck and Billy Ray, with his charm, humor, and wit, manly woodsman, though with the ladies a hit. The lure of the trees has kept him sane, and with an axe and McCulloch, he has made his name. I really like that. Life is a spirit river, or so it is said. Buckin has had a rough journey, but he came back from the dead. Hardship and suffering tempers the steel. It has given such men a heart from which they feel. Buddy, you're good at this. You are. Kindness, acceptance, and charity are spread from the home of this. Damn. Sorry. Oh. Sorry, friends. Kindness, acceptance, and charity are spread from the home of this man, breaking down fear, discrimination, isolation, like few others can. An infectious energy, free for all who thirst. His love of others will always come first. I pray that you long continue to shine your light, and the forces of darkness you passionately fight. Good brother, to you I raise a glass and toast to you with half a century past, 50. You are blessed like all who swing the axe, honest sweat, strong arms and back. In dark woods of the night, you will not be alone, for the spirit of the old woodsman will guide you home. Step confidently out on the shadowy trail to your welcoming fire, where you will share your tale. For the story continues to unfold from this man who is honest, modest, yet bold. Woodsman Spirit, April 3rd, 2019. That was hard. That was hard for me to get through. I forgot about this. This happened to me when I read it the first time, but not like this. Friends, this community of people, I don't give a crap. I don't give a crap about people seeing me get emotional. It makes no sense. It makes no difference to me. None whatsoever. I'm a human freaking being. I'm a man. Woodsman, you are blessed with the gift of poetry, buddy. That is beautiful. That is beautiful. Thank you so much for that. I wanted to share this. That was hard for me to get through, friends. There is a bigger thing than you and I. There is a much bigger thing than you and I, friends. Thanks, Woodsman. I love all you people. Thank you for coming to this channel. Damn, Woodsman.
There we go. Get your filing down to a science. It'll make your day go way easier. As soon as you hit something, just stop, friends. Stop. Stop and file. You're just gonna burn yourself out, and you're gonna hurt the saw and your arms and everything. You'll notice I don't count my strokes. I never have. and never will. So Shawshank, are you coming to Buckinsuck or what's going on? People are asking, they're wondering about you. He was the fella that took me to Sweden back in the day. My first real YouTube adventure. Crazy. Oh yeah, we got issues here. Hey? Some people learn from just watching, friends. We'll go see if this thing wants to pull some fur out of the fur log there. Here's our last tooth right here. Well, I can't believe I cut with this. Actually, you know what? We may not need to do rakers. Let's check them. So now I'll go back to this side because I file right hand with my rakers and I file them all the same direction. I don't think we're gonna need to, actually. You know what? It literally takes a moment, friends. And actually we do. We do need to. Let's do it. I got some crazy dog on this saw. You can put your bar down if you want, friends, if it's easier, and then just lift it when you turn. Put it back down softly, right? Lift it, turn it. Oh yeah, we need it to do rakers. Absolutely. Drop it back down. Up, turn, down. Wow. Up, slide back. Amazing. Let's go see how this cuts, hey friends, shall we? After a good filing, tailgate filing. Let's see if we can dig into some fur in the field there. I'm on the soft wood setting because it's skip tooth. If it was full house, I think I would probably go with the hard. Can't deal with this file anymore. Good one for sharpening my axes, friends. Oh, there we go. New files are the king. Oh, look at that. Hello. This is gonna cut. The rakers were high too. See how fast this goes, friends, when you file one side? Just, you know what I mean? Like you don't have to go flipping your power saw around. You just file them all the one way. You keep that file pointing the same direction as you would file your chain. Oh, see, this was high. That would have been chattering like mad. Right? Wow. Oh, this might cut. Skip tooth chain, 32 inch bar. Go cut some stringy fur. Let's go have a look. We're done. I see it. We're at the end of it. Here we are. Wow, that first file was lacking, but we're gonna run with it. Let's go. Let's go to the field. That took us about 12 minutes. Let's see. I'm actually intrigued.
Well, no, I'm not. I know what's gonna happen. Oh dear. Hey. Let's see if it'll fire without a choke. No. Oh, maybe. Been down for a bit. power saw. That's awesome.
Oh, friends, I'm making an axe for a guy. His wife called. It's actually, it's a Monster Michigan style. Have a vintage handle. I'll show it to you. The guy's got to know how to swing an axe, though. Friends, here it is right here. It's a vintage handle. It even smells old and bone dry. This is heartwood. It's all heartwood, which means the brown dead wood inside the tree. And the grain is ridiculous. I don't know if you'll see this, but I would think there's easily 50 grain across the handle. Easily. See if you can see it. You can see it. The camera's deadly. Look at it, friends. Look at the grain. It's on a 45, which is tough, because 45, you get it, doesn't know what it wants to be. So it's just like a mutt dog. It's strong. Yes, it is. What am I doing here? Oh, yeah. We gotta straighten this out. There's the before. It's in bad, bad shape. Really bad shape. Ready? You can actually touch it after you do that. Look, it does nothing to the temper. It's sandpaper. It's not, doesn't get hot. That's what I love about this. Getting there. See the face is shrunk now. Friends, do not be afraid of this stuff. What freaks people out is the temper. You're going to screw the temper. Don't heat it up. It's the only thing you got to worry about. Don't be afraid of this stuff. It ain't brain science. It's not. And nor is it rocket science, as a matter of fact. Friends, I'm a simple, simple man. Okay? I am a simple fellow. I'm good with physics. I'm good with my hands. I know that I need to make a couple of angles, and it has to be sharp, and it can't have a burr that's too sharp and for what I do. Friends, find some techniques that you can work with, something that works with for you, whatever you got with your tools. That freaking sander got given to me. I use the bonanzas out of that thing. I love it. Don't be afraid of sharpening your own axes, friends. It is not science.
I went to the factories in Sweden, both of them, and I saw how they do it. They do it like you and I do it. Go for it, friends. Get in there. Dig in. You'll feel so great when you get it done.
Wow. That's incredible what you can do, you know, friends. Like, look. It is not brain science. It's a steady hand and physics in your mind. We gotta straighten this out. There's the before. It's in bad, bad shape. It's coming up wonderful. Just putting a new bevel on it. That's all we're doing. We're nearly there. That's it.